This is Six Towns Radio.
And a very warm welcome to Parental Patter here on Six Towns Radio. You're listening to Carol Lovett and I'm going to be here with you through until 2 o'clock. Well, we have a very busy show ahead. We have Staffordshire Wildlife Trust coming in a little bit later around 1:15 and they're going to be talking about all the many, many activities that they're promoting locally over the summer holidays. We also have Lindsay Cairns on the programme and she's going to be talking about her imminent West End debut. Lindsay is a young singer. She's been on Six Towns before and I had the very great pleasure of seeing her at the Bertarelli Festival last Saturday evening, and I'm going to be talking more about that and giving you an update on it. We'll also be having a look at what's on locally for children and young people. So stay tuned because we've certainly got a lot ahead on the show today. Now, if you want to get in touch, you can email studio@sixtowns.co.uk, or a very good way to contact me is via the chat room. And as always, we'll be listening to all the best in music, and one of my favourite coming up now, it's The Clash and Rock the Casbah. Now, last Saturday evening I went off to the Regent Theatre where they had the Bertarelli Festival awards evening, and a really, really wonderful evening it was indeed. Lots of commuter groups performing on the stage. It's fantastic that such groups have an opportunity to express their talents and showcase their talents, and wonderful that Kirsty Bertarelli has invested so much money to actually promote the festival and safeguard it for the next 10 years. We've been talking about the festival a lot on the show. We had Ian Moore in a couple of weeks ago, and he is the Creative Learning Director at the Regent Theatre, and really it's been Ian's baby to nurture the festival and promote it and develop it, and I think big congratulations to Ian if you are listening, because you did a fantastic job. Now, the opening night, the opening act on the awards night was a wonderful young singer called Lindsay Cairns, and I'm very delighted to say that Lindsay's here in the studio with me with her mother Lindy. So welcome to Six Towns.
Hi.
Hello.
Now, did you feel nervous, Lindsay, doing that opening number on the awards evening?
Well, you know, it was a bit weird because, you know, my first show was at the Regent Theatre, and to be back there opening a show, singing solo, it just felt fantastic, if I'm honest. It was amazing.
I can imagine. And it went down so well, didn't it?
Yes, you know, it was fab. Yeah.
It was a wonderful, wonderful performance. So now, I explained earlier that you're an aspiring young singer, and you're clearly going on to wonderful things because you have your West End debut, don't you, in August?
Yes, I do.
Do you feel nervous about that?
Oh, I'm really excited. You know, West End, it's always been my goal, and to actually perform on there, it's just amazing.
Absolutely.
Can't describe it.
Well, of course, you first came to my attention when you did a charity event for Six Towns Radio and Donna Louise at Badley Green Working Men's Club.
Gosh.
And I saw you and I thought, wow, that's amazing. She's amazing. And then someone said you were 15.
Oh, I think I was 13 at the time.
13?
Like, yeah,
okay.
It must have been.
And I couldn't believe it. So, I mean, clearly you're having a bit of a meteoric rise here, aren't you? Because, you know, to think that you're going to go off to the West End now is phenomenal. So how old are you now, Lindsay?
I'm 15.
So you're 15,
yes.
Now. Yeah, okay. So I think you must have been 14 because it was probably about 6 months ago.
Right, yes, then it must have been.
So, I mean, I've been having a chat about where you first developed your singing talent. So how long have you been singing? Are you one of these people who started when you were about four?
Oh, no. it's quite a recent thing, if I'm honest with you. I'd started, you know, my passion was dancing at first. And one of my teachers actually turned around and said, you know, if you want to make it anywhere in the profession, then you need to learn how to sing. And, you know, I was just one of these people who would sing in the bathroom, like a wannabe Christina Aguilera and all this. So my mum and dad took me to a first singing lesson, thinking, you know, she'd just turn around and say, oh, you know, just keep up with the dancing, you'll be fine at that, I'm sure. But no, she just turned around and said, you've got a fabulous voice. And we were like, sorry, what? So yeah, from then on it's just grown and it's just been a love of mine.
And that's been over the last couple of years then, has it?
Yes, yeah, it's quite a recent thing.
So, Linda, when did it come to your attention that you had such a talented daughter?
I think initially it was dancing. She wanted to dance from the age of about three. It didn't really take off till she was about five, and we knew from the age of five we'd got a performer. We could see she was a different person when she was on the stage. And the singing. The singing now has way outdone the dancing. She gets invited to so many shows, charity shows, professional shows, and it's the singing that people. It's quite a shock because we don't know where it came from. People think she's got it from either myself or her dad, but no, it was just there lurking. But no, she's fabulous. We're really, really proud of her.
I can imagine, actually. And I think it's funny when you say, like, it was a shock, because my goddaughter, who lives in Huddersfield, she's developed this talent as well that seems to have come out of nowhere. And she's planning to go on to do opera. Classical music at college. She's just finishing her GCSEs. And her mother has said the same thing. It was only a couple of years ago that suddenly this voice appeared. And it was, well, where's that come from? Because nobody has any kind of creative singing talent in the family. But she has this amazing, amazing voice. And now she's been chosen as one of the choir for the Olympics. So she's going to be performing at the Olympics with the Olympics choir.
Strange you say that. Lindsay's actually performing in the village.
Oh, are you?
She's actually been in.
Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. So, obviously, you were at high school when this all started to develop. But now, of course, you're at a very specialist school, aren't you, for specifically your talents?
Yes, a vocational school in Chester called the Hammond School, yes.
Okay, so what made you decide to kind of go down that path rather than just take additional lessons in the evenings and the weekends? Why concentrate so fully on it at this point, rather than, say, stay in high school and take your GCSEs?
Well, you know, I didn't want to give up the dancing and I didn't want to stop my singing or narrow the classes down. But as well as being at school, I wasn't finished dancing until about 9:30, and it was getting a lot considering my GCSEs and everything that was coming up. And then, you know, I auditioned at Sylvia Young's, got down to, like, the final 10 out of 200. You know, it was fantastic. But we realised that by going to the Hammond, I was able to fit in my dancing, my singing and my academic and still have time for myself at night to study or practice. It was just a lot easier now.
It must have been a really big move for you as well, because it's over at Chester. Do you commute or do you board?
Well, last year I boarded, but yeah. I didn't really get on a lot with the girls that were boarding, and I found it quite difficult being away from home. Mm. But no, Mum and Dad moved down to me this year, so it's been a lot easier. A lot easier.
Oh, I can imagine, actually. And Chester's a very nice place and not too far away. And it's a perfect location then for the north and kind of heading down to the south as well, because you're close to Crewe, aren't you? And you can easily get all over the country for performance.
Yeah, it's just the long journeys to London that are, you know, crazy.
Yes, I can imagine. So how long will you stay at school?
I've got 1 year left and then it's time to move to college.
And she can actually stay on at the Hammond. She does get the option to actually stay there and to audition and stay for the seniors.
Yes.
But I think Lindsay wants to head off down to London.
Oh, okay, so you're going to head down to London, down to the Big Smoke, of course, where you're going to be so then accessible for auditions, aren't you?
Yes.
Which is the key thing. Okay, right, it's a delight to actually talk more about this, and I want to very much find out what's going to be happening in August in London. But we'll take a break now and have a little bit more music and come back in a minute.
That's great.
Six Towns Radio.
You're listening to Parental Patter here on Six Towns Radio, and I'm talking to Lindsay and Linda Kearns. Lindsay, an aspiring young singer who's about to go off to the West End. Now, you mentioned that obviously you're at this specific school now for training people in dance and singing and the creative arts, I would imagine. And your parents have now moved over to you in Chester to support you. I find that very, very interesting, because I think it just emphasises the investment that families have to really put in if they want their young children or, you know, their young artists, aspiring artists, to actually go further.
Absolutely.
Have you found that? Has it been a big sacrifice? Well, sacrifice in the nicest possible way, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, absolutely. It's you do need quite a dedicated team, either mum or dad, or I'm just taxi service, really. We tend to, if it's something in London that she's doing, if it's an audition, we tend to have to get her there first thing in the morning, and then we're just left to roam until 5 p.m. or whatever time to pick her up. So I mean, sometimes it's hard to do that, We just left sitting around for 3, 4, 5 hours at a time. Financially, it takes an awful lot sometimes to back Lindsay, not only because the dance classes and the singing lessons, none of them are free. So yeah, it's, you've got to be dedicated. If we weren't dedicated, Lindsay just couldn't have done it. Because sometimes we've had to go from Hanley off to Burslem, off to Brown Edge, and without somebody there to do all that, it's not possible. But I also I've had to learn to use computers. I need to edit songs, I need to download, I need to spend countless hours on the computer looking for backing tracks.
Your talents would be very useful here at Six Times, actually. When you just said you learned to edit tracks, because I know they're trying to get me into editing, but luckily I have a wonderful helper now who's very technological, but I'm the least technological of people. But it's interesting what you say, Linda, because the investment and the financial mm-hmm. one could be a deterrent for some people, because it is costly, isn't it?
It's very costly. We've actually sold a house to try and raise the funds, because obviously she goes to a private school.
Yes.
And everything about a private school is paid for.
Yes.
She's very fortunate now. She's actually been awarded an MDA award, which means this final year, it's completely free, which is such a relief, because we were struggling such a lot financially.
Yes.
We've got her this far. Now we hope that her talents will pull her through.
Yes, gosh, that's absolutely marvellous. And you know, again, it does link into the sacrifice people have to make if they want to really promote and, you know, get their young children and young artists onto, you know, a higher springboard, really, to go further. But hopefully, I mean, you will be rewarded.
I think we just knew that Lindsay could be the performer that
Absolutely.
She wants to be. We could see the spark that was there, and people used to say she is a natural performer.
Absolutely. And I can't get over, when I watch Lindsay, how powerful her voice is. I mean, it's the voice of, well, I thought it, as I say, I was astounded about your age. I thought it was the voice of a much older, experienced person. It's immensely powerful. Where does that power come from?
I have no idea, you know. It's just like, just singing lessons, and then they tell you to use all your diaphragm, and it's like, sorry, what? I don't know, to be honest. It's just there. It's just there.
Yes, well, we're hoping to hear some music from you a little bit later.
Yes.
So that people can actually hear what you sound like. But, I mean, you clearly have a wonderful talent, and that's being nurtured now by the right people, you know, the experienced people who can then move you on to much better things. Now, talking of which, I mean, the big thing that really excited me was this opportunity for you that's developing in the West End. Because immediately when I saw Lindsay for the first time, I thought, you've got a voice, you're a West End person, you've got that West End voice, a voice for the musicals. I know that you have all sorts of genres under your belt.
Yes.
But I have been a person who watches a lot of musicals, goes to the theatre and has done for many, many years. Immediately I could see you in the musicals. I mean, is that something that you do see as a future option, or are you thinking more of, you know, recording and performing and just doing a whole variety?
Well, no, musicals. I love musicals. Like, when I was in London, I went down to watch Chicago. I was blown away. It was fantastic. Absolutely amazing.
Yes.
West End.
Yes.
Yeah, musicals.
And, of course, better do a plug here for the region. That Chicago is coming to the region.
Yes.
In Hanley in September. And I have to say, I have seen it a couple of years ago at the Regent, and it's one of my very, very favourite musicals.
Fabulous.
It is fabulous.
Yes.
It really is. So that's the sort of thing you see yourself performing in
yes.
the future.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so what's this that's materialising? Is it called 13?
Yes, it's just come straight from Broadway. So it's the first time it's been performed in America, I mean, in England, even.
Yes.
And the director that actually wrote the musical is directing it in the show that I'm doing. So, you know, it's just fantastic.
And what is it about?
It's basically about 13-year-olds that are growing up. So, you know, the teenage stage of boyfriends and going to movies and all your homework, you know. It's yes. just a funny show. It's really good.
And so it's a musical. I mean, is it gonna hopefully develop a little bit along the lines of Fame or something like that, a musical for young people? Or
Yeah, that is actually what I think it is. And it's a fabulous... Lindsay's in that age now where she can't really find a place to be. She's too old to be a child, but she's not old enough to be an adult. Mm. And there's basically not an awful lot around. Yes. So this is an actual perfect scenario for Lindsay. She is allowed to be a teenager. So yeah, it is fun. It's fun to watch. I mean, we didn't know an awful lot about it. We googled it like you do everything. Mm. But no, it is really, really fun musical, and it is just about being 13.
Okay, that sounds great. And what's your role in it, Lindsay?
I'm playing Molly.
Okay, and Molly is what? She's just a 13-year-old.
She's she's a cheerleader in it, actually.
Oh, is she? So, you know, yeah. I could see you as a cheerleader.
Yeah, big gymnastics. So yeah, fantastic.
You've also got that kind of face, you know, that real kind of cheery face, haven't you? I could just see you with the pom poms.
Well, I used to do a lot of gymnastics.
Did you?
Yes, I did. But you know, I was building up the wrong muscles, and you know, I didn't want that if I was going to be a dancer and getting too much of a bendy back.
Yes.
So, you know, it was one thing or the other.
And then, of course, talking about gymnastics and linking into the Olympics, you're going to be performing, like you said earlier, in the Olympic Village. Will you actually get to watch any of the Olympics?
I don't think so, no. But, you know, just to perform in front of the village is just an amazing opportunity.
It is an amazing opportunity. How did it fit in with your education when you told your school? Where were you, by the way? Where did you go before going on to the one that you're at now?
I was in St Margaret Ward.
St Margaret Ward, okay. Yes, of course, I know it. So, oh my goodness, that has heritage. That's where Robbie Williams went.
Yes.
Okay, I can see it's a place that breeds talent, isn't it? So what did they say when you said you were going off to somewhere else?
Well, you know, all the teachers, they were chuffed for me. And when I was performing the other night at the Regent, one of my old teachers was there, and she came out. She was like, I can't believe how much you've grown into performing. You're amazing. And I remember there was like once a photo shoot that I had in the studio at St Margaret Ward's that went into the Sentinel. And, you know, she was just like, I remember you posing for these pictures, and to see you now, it's just... amazing.
I tell you what, it is impressive. It's impressive for that school, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
You know that they have such talent that develops there. It's absolutely wonderful. We'll take a little break now, and then we'll come back and find out what else the future holds for you.
Definitely.
Six Towns Radio.
And welcome back to Parental Patter, just played Three in a Row by the Doors. But now we have the pleasure to listen to Lindsay Cairns singing one of her songs called... what is it called? Lossie. I just went a blank there. I have actually heard you singing this before at the Regent. And I must confess, it's absolutely wonderful. So just give me a minute, Lindsay, and then we will hear you in action.
We always seem to be sister and brotherly, it's such a lovely way to be. And I want to say what it means to me, how I could never be the same without you. And something more than I know, though I never could show, how it kept right on growing. The way I know I really feel about you, the way I know I'll always feel about you. Why can't we, why can't we, why can't we try to play a love scene? We don't need the violin love scene, where we see how love begins, find a way to start, and learn to play the part of a perfect scene from a play unknown. Let's play a love of our own. what it means to me. How I could never be the same without you. Something more than I know, though I never could show how it kept right on growing. The way I know I really feel about you, the way I know I'll always feel about you. Why can't we, why can't we, why can't we try to play a love scene? We don't need the violins to play a love scene, where we see how love begins. If we could find a way to start and play it from the heart of a perfect scene, from a play unknown, let's play a love scene, love scene of our
absolutely wonderful.
Mind the cold.
Absolutely stunning, honestly. So you're so confident when you do it as well, aren't you?
Oh, I just love it. It's like I'm in my own world. It's amazing.
I can imagine, actually. I can imagine. Well, it's an absolute joy to hear the actual voice as well. You did do that one at the Bertarelli launch, didn't you?
Did I?
You sang it well,
accompanied
you on the piano. Yes. No, I thought it was Meryl Streep. Yeah.
That was the other one from Fame.
Yeah, because there was a couple that you did at the launch, wasn't there?
Yes.
Oh, absolutely wonderful. So when you go to auditions, is that one of the ones that you do? Is that like in your repertoire?
It's not. I actually did this song at the Regent Theatre in the musical Fame. Yeah, yes. They did the show there. Yes. And I played the part of Serena Katz, and that was one of her songs.
Yeah, okay, that was a recognition of it then, actually. Yes. It's in Fame.
Yes.
Ah, well, absolutely wonderful. Well, come and sit yourself down, okay. Because I think you deserve a rest after that. So, you know, when you hear that, Linda, I mean, I can't even imagine what you must feel. You must just be so proud.
Absolutely. When she's first practicing them, I'm trying to record it as well, and there's so many times I'm actually trying to stop myself from sobbing.
I can imagine, because I actually felt quite emotional listening to her then. You know, yeah. I could have easily shed a tear because she has that emotion, doesn't
absolutely.
She?
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely.
Voice, you know, which makes it so perfect for the musicals as well, because I know we were talking about this earlier, but you've got to be multi-talented, haven't
yes,
you?
Yes, definitely.
You've got to be able to really get the message across, not just sing the message. It's the acting as well.
This is it. Well, as I've always tried to explain to it, that a song is actually a play, and within that song, the whole thing has a meaning, and that's basically, she just puts her acting into it. But I just think it comes naturally anyway. But sometimes some of the songs she needs to understand the meaning in the song, and some songs she's only 15, and when you talk about love and she's not experienced that feeling yet, so I guess it's kind of difficult for her.
Yes.
But she does a tremendous job.
But of course, really, it's like a good wine. You're only going to get better and better and better, aren't you? You know what I mean? And be able to actually then transfer the feeling and experience that, you know, you have through your own life.
Well, yes. Like, I used to experience, like, I've been bullied quite a bit. So some of the songs are like, you know, forget what people have said. You need to carry on with life. You know, you've got a whole future ahead of you. You just need to look at what you want to do. And, you know, having experienced all that, I'm really able to involve myself in the songs. which makes it a lot easier and, you know, can sometimes move people, so.
Yes, absolutely. Well, it definitely moved me, I have to say, because, you know, the actual passion that came across there and the emotion, it was just so very, very evident. So after the Olympics, you're then back for your final year at this, you know, the school in Chester, and then you'll be moving on to hopefully better and greater things in London.
Yes, it's a bit scary, but, you know, it's what I've dreamt of, you know.
I can imagine so far you've put more into your lifetime than many people do who are like twice, three times your age. It's absolutely phenomenal. So what I want to say is thank you so very, very much for coming on to Parental Patter.
It's been great. I've really enjoyed it.
It's been a complete pleasure to have you here. And I've so enjoyed listening to you sing. And I hope to hear you many, many more times in the future, which I think all of us will.
Clearly. Hopefully. Fingers crossed.
Oh, yeah. Undoubtedly. Undoubtedly. So I hope you'll come back again.
Oh, definitely.
You know, in due course. Would love to have you on. Particularly if you have anything in particular to promote, like, you know, an album, you know, that you need to promote. Because you have actually released a CD, haven't you?
I have.
Can you tell us how we could get hold of that?
Well, that would be my mother.
At the moment, it's not actually in selling production.
Okay.
That was just something that we put together so that Lindsay could actually feel, reap the rewards, as it were, and she could actually see how it would be if she were to do an album. And it was professionally recorded, it's just the artwork has actually been handmade by myself.
It's a wonderful one because, you know, I have it myself because you're using it for promotional
Absolutely.
Purposes, of course.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And, yeah, and I've played it to many in my family who all say, how old is she? And your picture as well, how old is she? So clearly, you know, very, very talented indeed. So what about a website where people can find out information?
It's actually in the process at the moment of being set up. She's actually widely available on YouTube if anyone wants to go and have a look at what she's done on there.
Most definitely.
And most of the links for Lindsay are actually on the internet, as it were. She's got a Facebook account.
Yeah.
And
yes. You can add me on Facebook, Lindsay Jenkins.
Yeah. Oh, very good. So there are ways that people can actually
absolutely.
Make contact.
Yes.
Okay, that's absolutely wonderful. Well, thank you so much for coming into Six
Towns. It's been a pleasure. Thank you very much.
And I wish you all the very best in the future.
Thank you.
Thank you.